Hello, my name is Cho Soo-bin in first grade at Diasa. I'm going to talk about the importance of polar region and the advancement of Korea to polar regions. Polar areas are land located at both ends of the Earth and remain the only unexplored land on Earth due to extreme climates and extreme positions. Thanks to the cold climate and regional characteristics, the entire polar region is enough to be a scientific laboratory. Polar research becomes more important because Antarctica is the largest unit ecosystem on Earth and the Arctic holds the key to global warming. Korea is actively entering and conducting research in the polar region, although it is not as old as other countries. I'm going to introduce about the polar research of our country and the work to do. Antarctica is very important because of its southern ice fisheries resources, oil and natural gas, metal minerals, and non-preserved resources, which are expected to be in Antarctica and its surrounding waters. Korea gained the status as a member of the Antarctic Treaty Consultative Party in 1989 and is conducting active Antarctic research. There are two science bases that were established in Antarctica for full-fledged Antarctic research, the Sejong Science Base and the Jangbogo Science Base. The Sejong Science Base is responsible for research on the marine environment and coastal ecology, while the Jangbogo Science Base is mainly responsible for research on the impact of Antarctica on the Earth, such as Pacific climate change, glaciers, meteorites, marine ecosystems, and high-rise atmosphere. Also, studies are being conducted through the icebreaker Araun, which travels between the South and North Poles. The Arctic is home to 21,000 species, including polar bears. Glaciers in the Arctic are melting at a rapid pace as global warming accelerates. This has made it relatively easy to collect huge amounts of oil, gas, and minerals buried in the Arctic, and several countries are competing for control of the Arctic region because the routes can be opened and used commercially. In 2000, for the first time, Korea participated in the International Polar Science Committee as an observer state and expressed interest to the world. Korea built a Dasan Science Base in the North Pole in 2002. At the Dasan Science Base, about 60 researchers conduct research every summer in various fields, such as sea ice analysis, atmospheric observation, climate change research, and ecosystem monitoring. Now, I'll talk about the efforts our country has to make inroads into the polar region. First, various education on polar areas should be implemented. Most students are often not interested in the scientific and economic values of the poles. These problems of education should be improved to train professionals who do polar research. Second, polar research activities at the national level should be activated. Increasing the budget allocated to polar research and supporting domestic research personnel and data will further boost polar research. Third, we need a long-term polar advancement policy that analyzes and sets the international situation on the future polar region, not a short-term polar policy. Finally, the government should actively protect the polar regions. Polar research is very important, but policy on it is also necessary because it is very important to protect and preserve polar areas. Polar areas are a very important part of the Earth where greater value is found as research progresses. Taking a late step in polar research, Korea should further boost polar research to lay the foundation for its advancement into the polar region. Thank you.